Hi guys, thank you for tuning in. In this video, we are going to talk about a very elementary concept associated with engineering, that is average value of a voltage wave or current wave. The definition of average value says, average value of AC is equivalent to the steady current which transfers the same amount of charge in a given time as transferred by an AC across the same circuit in the same time. If you have studied any derivation on this, it looks like this, and the end result reads 2 by pi or 0.6366 times Vm or Im, depends on the derivation. Since the definition says AC is equivalent to DC when we talk about average value, I'm going to use the concept of areas and compare as to what magnitude of AC wave occupies the same area as a DC wave. Consider a XY plane and a DC signal with a magnitude M. Include an AC signal with a peak of same magnitude M. Now, if you calculate the area occupied by the DC signal till the end of AC cycle, that is from 0 to 2 pi, the area will turn out to be M into 2 pi. Now, let us see how much area does an AC signal of the same magnitude occupy. For this, we integrate the sine wave from 0 to 2 pi. Interestingly, this area will turn out to be 0 because it is clearly seen that the positive half area will cancel out the negative half area. So we cannot compare these two signals over a time period of 2 pi. Let's reduce the time period and consider only one half cycle, that is from 0 to pi. Take the signals again. Area occupied by the DC signal this time is going to be M into pi. To calculate the area under the AC signal, integrate it from 0 to pi along with its magnitude. From the waveform, you can easily see that AC is going to occupy lesser area than the DC. And if you calculate the answer to the integral, it is going to be 2 into M, which is definitely lesser than the area under the DC wave. So what to do if we want to get the same area as that under the DC? The time period under consideration is fixed. We cannot change it. The only possible solution available is to increase the magnitude of the AC wave. Now we can definitely do this till we find area occupied by both graphs to be equal. But to what extent do we increase the magnitude? Now if you observe, the previous AC area, if multiplied by pi by 2, then the 2 will cancel out from the numerator and denominator, and we will get M into pi. This is exactly the area under the DC curve. It means the new magnitude of the AC wave has to be M into pi by 2 instead of the old value M. Plot this wave with a magnitude of M into pi by 2. This curve is going to be higher than the earlier AC wave. The area under this curve will be integral of the wave along the magnitude. And the final answer will turn out to be M into pi, which is matching with the area under the DC wave. So you can conclude that this wave is identical to the DC wave under consideration, and it is possible to calculate average value of this wave. We do this by integrating the wave from limits 0 to pi. And since we are finding the average and not area, divided by the number of divisions, which is pi in this case. The answer will turn out to be value M, which was the magnitude of our DC wave. In simple words, if you take a sine wave and multiply it by 2 by pi, you will get the average value of that sine wave. Hope you found this useful. Do share your views about it and subscribe to never miss an update from Explanator, where every solution has a simple explanation.